Hey guys, good morning. Welcome back to 1 Minute CM2. Today we have Dr. Deepthika Kashyap, who's a doctor in anesthesia, and she's practicing in Yamunanagar, which is in Haryana. She's been a past president for Indian Society of Anesthesia, Haryana State Branch, and she's also successfully conducted a lot of anesthesia conferences in the city, and you know, she's been a delegate for a lot of conferences. She is also an executive member for Haryana IMA Women's Wing, which is basically Indian Medical Association Women's Wing. And under this particular banner, apart from her regular work, she believes in doing a lot of social activity. And she basically uplifts a lot of underprivileged women. And she believes in creating awareness for adolescent girls, girls who are at the age of 19, I mean, between 10 to 19. She believes in creating awareness programs for girls who are anemic, don't really take care of their health, their menstrual hygiene. You know, also teaches them about good touch and what is bad touch when they're in this society. And these are few things she does. Apart from this particular association, does a lot of activities which are for the underprivileged, you know, society or socioeconomic status. And apart from this, the main reason she is here is, apart from being a doctor, she is also passionate about learning Kathak. She has done some programs, wonderful programs about Kathak. And she also does, you know, whenever she is free, she believes in doing crochet at home and embroidery and stuff like that. So that's her passion. I mean, this is one example where she is living her passion, you know, instead of just getting stuck with her work as a doctor. So thank you, ma'am. Thank you for being here. I mean, we're really honored that you've joined us here in this particular situation. And you know, it is, you know, I'm still surprised how are you balancing both the profiles. Matlab ek profile hai jisme aap, I mean, you're doing Kathak. Kathak is an art dance where you are like enjoying every part of your body, and you know, you're feeling good. And there is another profession where you're almost making the other person, you know, paralyzed. So this is complete.
Yeah. You know. Thank you, Ravi, for having me here. It's a pleasure to be here. First of all, let me congratulate you for inviting people, common people like us, on this platform and making feel as if we are a big celebrity, you know. And apart from that, yes, I am balancing a lot of work along with my professional and in my personal career. I am a passionate doctor. I am an anesthesiologist who has to work in a lot of under a lot of pressure, and we have stressful environments in operation theaters. At the same time, I am trying to learn Kathak, perform on stage, and carry on with my passions of sitting at home, not sitting idle, but doing something or the other, you know, creating things, small things, which can, which I can use, or my children can use later on, or everybody feels happy about it, that I can make a balance, perfect balance between my personal life and my career, at the same time taking care of my children as well. And not to forget about the society, which has given me so much.
Yeah.
I want to return back to the society by working for the underprivileged, especially young girls. I can understand, being female, I can understand the problems they go through their lives because of the system of our system in which we are living, the poverty which they have to face. At least maybe sometime, someday, I can make some small difference in life of some person or the other. That will be very much satisfying for me.
That's true. I mean, it is taking time out, and especially when you're doing these activities, you know, in some of these areas which need a lot of education, it takes a lot of effort to travel there, you know, gather people, do this education, which is really useful for them. But sparing time, a lot of people feel that mere paas ye time nahi hai. It's so, you know, grateful that you took time out of your hectic schedule, and then, you know, you continued your passion and also, you know, some of these social activities. That's really commendable. But how did you start all this?
See, these things are important to prioritize our work.
Mm-hmm.
I think everything is freezed.
Yeah, I think the internet is... Are you able to hear me okay?
I can hear you. Can you see me? Can you
yeah.
hear me?
Yes, I can see you and hear you clearly. Yeah.
Okay. Well, I have prioritized my life. You know, I know where my priorities lie. Initially, when I was studying, priorities were studies. I was a very good student in my studies. Definitely, I got through in the first attempt. I got through my MBBS entrance exam. Then I keep coming and going, you know, keep prioritizing, jumping between one job and the other, you know, multitasking at a time. So my computer is also doing the same thing, you know, multitasking.
Yeah. But when did you decide that you want to become anesthesia? Why anesthesia? Why did you want to freeze people? Ki, yeah, iska heart.
When I was doing my MBBS, as other doctors, I always thought of becoming a surgeon or a gynecologist naturally. And then we're posted in different specialties. When I was, my rotation was in an anesthesia department. I realized that anesthesiologist is a complete doctor. He's an intensivist. They are the best at resuscitating patients. Then they are getting all sort of surgeries in one day. I mean, they are getting a pediatric surgery done at the same time. In another operation theater, neurosurgery is going on. They're looking after the trauma patients, and pain is the main forte of anesthesiologists. You know, they are best at relieving pain, and they are so smart people. I was very much intrigued by their personality as such in operation theater. They were everywhere in operation theaters. And then only I decided that, yes, this is the branch which intrigues me, which fascinates me. You know, I would also like to be like that, on the toes all the time. Yes. And then then and there only I decided that I have to be an anesthetist, right in the third year of my MBBS. And luckily I got good rank so that I could get admission into MD anesthesia. And today here I am, a proud anesthesiologist.
Nice. So have you tried this on your husband anytime?
God forbid, I don't want this thing to happen. Yes, anesthesia is basically to be provided, it's a service, you know, to be provided at the time of surgery.
True.
So I don't want my husband to go under the scalpel.
Madam, you know, you have these medical representatives who are always around you. Madam, ye acha, ye injection acha, you know, try this. This is like from the top brand. This is a new brand. Matlab check to karna hoga na, kaam kar raha hai ki nahi. How do you ensure that? There should be some people who try this and, you know, say that ye kaam kar raha hai.
Yes, anesthesiologists have a kitty of drugs. You know, we have a huge armamentarium of drugs. Our whole branch is dependent upon the drugs which we use in order to make our patients pain-free and surgeons comfortable getting a good field out of it so that they can operate upon a relaxed patient. But then, yes, we tend to, when a medical representative, they come with the drugs, we already know about the drugs. We have studied so much about all the drugs, and we have to keep studying so that we are updated. We're not trying anything new on our patients. We can't make our patients guinea pig, you know. These things are time tested in the laboratories. Then the studies have been carried out over the drugs. We have to just use them very judiciously and cautiously in our patients. I cannot try on my husband, you know.
No, that was on a lighter note. But, you know, I like the way, I mean, you're going through a stressful, you know, work. I mean, it's like back-to-back patients or back-to-back surgeries. And then, you know, once you come home, you're wearing a different hat altogether. You're like, okay, from Dr. Geetika to Geetika, who loves crochet and crochet. I mean, I hope that's the way it is spelled. Crochet, right?
Crochet.
Crochet is, yeah. Crochet, aajkal koi nahi kar raha. Matlab, women these days, or, you know, men to pehle se gone case. I mean, we've never tried it. I've not seen people.
You know, thanks to the technology, mobiles and internet, you know, everybody's busy on those things. We are losing our art, you know. Which I love doing that. This is a big stress buster. People come home. They take off their hats, their scrubs off, and then they are homemakers at home. I sit down on my couch with my crochet kit around me, and then it's just like meditating, you know. I don't need to listen to music or watching TV. That relieves me, that calms me down. And I can, you know, have so many thoughts internally. I can talk to myself internally. It's almost just like meditating for me. And at the same time, I'm learning new things all the time. So that keeps me going.
Yeah, it's I think one art, and a mix of a lot of patience and art. Yeah.
And learning, you know, learning all the time.
So what are the creative stuffs you created with your crochet?
I've made runners, placemats. I've gifted them to my friends. Recently, in the time of this corona and pandemic, I've made face masks with my crochet.
Wow.
I've made a few dresses for my daughter as well. When she was young, she used to love wearing those. Even she used to wear those.
Mommy, please don't do it. Don't expect us to wear it.
Recently I was telling Soumya, I'll crochet a bag for you. Mama, please keep that bag to yourself, you know.
That's nice. So we want to understand you well, ma'am. So, you know, we want to get into some rapid fire questions where we know, we know Dr. Geetika, and we know what you've achieved, what you do outside. But, you know, we also want to know behind the scenes of Geetika. And you know how she evolved. So where were you born and where were you brought up? Kaisa tha, how was your childhood?
Well, I was born and brought up in Gurgaon. My father was a senior divisional officer in BSNL, and my mother was a principal in government school. And my grandparents, they were living with us, along with my Tayajis and Tayajis, and I have a brother and two cousins. We were all living together. And we got a very good upbringing. My father was a very ethical kind of a person, a very religious and ethical person. He always used to tell us what is right, what is wrong. We should be always following the right path. And I was very much influenced by my father and his thinking. When I used to be studying in my room, we had this window in between our room, which has a glazed glass over it. And I could see that my father is awake, and I could hear even if I was used to be studying late hours of night at 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, he used to be sitting there in the room reading newspapers or his books, so that I have a moral support. Even at night time, he is there around in order to help me out. I mean, that kind of the environment I grew up. And later on, he was the one force behind me who motivated me to be a doctor. Not for the monetary gains, but in order to serve the society, you know, to be a good doctor who can serve the humanity and help people in pain.
Cool, ma'am. So we have your progress up on about Kathak, your performance there.
Yeah.
Kab ka photograph hai ye?
This is in 2019, last year.
Very recent. Okay.
Yeah, I have joined Kathak classes here. My guru is a disciple of Pandit Birju Maharaj. She's a wonderful person. I mean, she's the one who motivated me to join Kathak classes. I was initially very skeptical about my age and all. I was already 45 then, and starting Kathak at that age, I thought, maybe I'm not able to cope up with this. But then she told me that if I have passion, yes, I can do it. And we have a group of 4 or 5 ladies who are my age then who are following. And this particular dance performance, there was this, our academy, they were holding a performance of Kathak. It was a pure cultural evening. And there were many Kathak presentations by different age groups. And mine was among the ladies group, and we were performing on Krishna as usual. It was a great experience.
Correct me. You started learning Kathak at the age of 45.
Yes, quite late, you know.
Wow.
I was passionate about dance right from the beginning, but then I was so busy with my studies initially when I was in school, then college, then when I came here with my profession. Now that when I got the time, you know, I set my priorities according to that. Now when I have time, my children are grown up, I had time on my hand, which I could dedicate to another passion of myself, dance. And I got this great guru who could help me out in my passions. And she gave me a good platform where I could perform on the stage with wearing all those dresses, being dressed up. In fact, we were supposed to perform on 29th of March. We had our program, cultural evening. But because of the lockdown and COVID pandemic, it has been postponed.
But awesome. I mean, at the age of, I mean, you know, we had recently one of the guests, Madhuri ji, who started learning karate at the age of 39, and she got the black belt at the age of 42. And generally, it takes 5 years to receive the black belt. But you know, with her agility and you know strength, she got it in 2.5 years. Mm. Yeah, you have beaten her
record. Yes. well, I can say that if whenever God gives you time to invent yourself, I think we should go ahead. Age is no bar. I'm agile enough. I'm very much active. I'm into yoga. I'm into exercises. I'm into Zumba classes. So dance is another wow. type of exercise which helps me out, rejuvenating, and at the same time it gives me such a good platform wherever I can be myself. You know, I can dress up. I can enjoy all the limelight.
अच्छा ये बताइए आप हैव यू मिक्स्ड ज़ुम्बा एंड कथक एनी टाइम मतलब ज़ुम्बा का क्लास चल रहा है एंड यू डोंट नो व्हाट स्टेप्स टू डू एंड हैव यू परफॉर्मड एनी कथक
स्टेप्स यस आई डिड इट वंस सी अंडर द आई एम ए वुमेन्स विंग वी वर वंस होल्डिंग अ ज़ुम्बा क्लास फॉर ऑल द डॉक्टर्स फीमेल डॉक्टर्स ऑफ यमुनानगर एंड वी इनवाइटेड ऑल द डेंटल सर्जन्स अलॉन्ग विद अस And there, the Zumba was going on, and I mean, some time in between, I felt like, oh, come on, I'll go backstage. I went behind everyone, and then I started doing my kathas, you know, a small tukna which I had learned recently. And the person on the stage, they could see me, and later on, they said, ma'am, what were you doing then? They're standing there. I could see you doing something different, you know. I was busy enjoying myself, you know.
Yeah, this is like that moment. मतलब DJ चल रहा है गाना स्टेज में, you know, it's all excited and suddenly DJ plays a very slow song and people wait, कुछ steps नहीं आ रहा, they don't have anything, they start doing this garba, you know, dandiya steps.
Or the Himachali dance, you know, the slow ones. Yes, it was something that kind of a moment for me. I basically enjoy. I feel if I'm dancing. I danced as if nobody's watching. I mean, I'm free. I want to dance. Okay, enjoy. If you enjoy watching me, good. Now, if you're not, okay, then walk ahead. I enjoy dancing.
Yeah, आजकल मेरे guests पूरे यही बोल रहे हैं. You know, enjoy. Enjoy as if nobody is watching. It's a good
see,
one.
See, this try. Pandemic has done a great thing on the to the people. You know, I think they have given this pandemic, this lockdown has given people some time to sit down, relax, and think about themselves. And prioritize their things. I mean, this is really helping people out. The best of them is coming out, I think, in this this yeah. time.
And that uncertainty kal hai ho na ho. Let me enjoy this moment and
enjoy this moment.
Family, you know,
yeah, people come to know that life is very simple. We don't require many big gadgets in our life to enjoy. And simple home cooked food. Time spent with family, this rejuvenates us better than going ahead watching movie on I mean out going outside enjoying our family vacations outside. I think home is the best place where you can enjoy.
Yeah. Your next picture, can you talk about this particular picture?
This is a batch reunion. We had a batch reunion recently, our MBBS batch. Our MBBS mm-hmm. batch is very active socially as well as meeting and you know arranging meetings with each other. We passed out, we were 89 batch when we got admission in our medical college in the year 1989. So ours is the 89 batch and ours is the I think one of the most happening batch of our medical college. Now we keep meeting after every few years and this is the one which yes we met in last year only in 2019. This picture is of that. We really had blast.
मतलब यहाँ पे मतलब वुमेन डोमिनेशन कुछ ज्यादा ही दिख रहा है मेरे को यहाँ पे.
Our batch was that we had around 150 students in our batch and majority were girls. It was a change in our time, you know. Ours was the batch which had majority of females in our batch. We dominate the boys in our batch. Yes. We don't That's let them funny. Speak even on our social media group, you know. We are the ones who rule there.
Isme you know name one know, friend of yours, woman friend, and, you know, one guy who were the naughtiest of all. Pure batch mein, matlab Allah, pure MBBS mein, that 4 years, you know, they were the naughtiest and, you know, most famous.
The naughtiest one, unfortunately, could not attend this meet. He's not there. He was almost just like the gang of three idiots, you know, in our batch. He couldn't make this in this and that. In the, he's a surgeon now. He's practicing in Rewari, in a town in Haryana. I mean, okay. He used to be very naughty. And in this batch, we have quite good people. Yes, there's a person, Dr. Amit. He came all the way from UK to attend this batch reunion, and he enjoyed and made us laugh throughout the meeting. We had this thing. Then we had Samiksha here. I think she'll be listening to me as well. She's in America now, and she gave us such good time, and she has such sense, good sense of humor, and perfect timing. And she catches you there and then only, and tells you, "Hey, this is the thing you're doing." She has those tones, you know. And I love to talk to her. And when I went on this batch reunion, she came. She got me a book on crochet. She knows me so well. And even I didn't know myself so well. She knows me. It's good. Good to have such good friends. Then there's Anjali as well, who's the one, the boss, you know, who arranges all the batch reunions and makes things happen in the right manner. She's a good. We freeze over here.
No, it's fine. We can see you properly. Yeah.
Can you hear?
Yeah, we can.
So this is ours is a group of varied people. You know, some have interest in only in medical science. Some have interest in varied meeting people. Some are always joyous. I forget to mention about Sanjay Duhan. He's in UK at the moment, but very naughty, and he's got all the quirky comments coming on our social media.
So isme they would have, you know, formed lot of couples where, you know, your batch was like, ha, ye dono bahar ja ke shaadi kar lenge. But
we have many couple friends here in this group. Indu Bansal, Himesh, then Vikas Majithia and Deepika. We have Sugit Baveja, Gitanjali Baveja. We have many. Nupur Narendra, who married in our batch. We have many of them.
So almost around 5 to 10 couples got formed here.
Yeah, maybe more. I'm not able to recollect their names.
That's awesome. Okay, yeah. So have you taken anesthesia on yourself anytime? Matlab, not you, but do you know how it works?
Yes. I have undergone surgery. I had an accident. I met with an accident. I had fractured my knee, and my surgery was carried out. Yes. And then later on, the implants were removed. So twice for that. Yes, I have undergone. Oh. Then I have got 2 daughters by cesarean section. So I have experienced anesthesia. Yes.
But why did you take this photograph then? You know, now you know how it feels and all that.
Where are you getting all these photos? I think Facebook. Yes. This is a photograph from China. I mean, we had gone to China way back there. We had gone, there was this statue, and it was very funny kind of. I just stood there. My husband clicked the photograph.
This is exactly how your patients feel, madam, when you give anesthesia. So, yeah.
I think so, yes. I wish I am like this, you know. I have to be like this. That's my job, to be robust and strong while standing in operation theater. Everything is, you know, everything is under the control of anesthesiologist. The patient, they're scared. We have to make sure that they're comfortable, pain-free. Then at the same time, surgeon, we have to make the surgeon comfortable by operating. The field should be immobile. The muscles should be relaxed. The temperature of the operation theater, that has also to be maintained. Oh. So we have to maintain an aura of just like this, like the warriors, you know, standing there. And we have to be pillar of strength to our surgeons. We don't have to make them panic, you know. Suppose something goes wrong, the patient's blood pressures, they're fluctuating. You don't have to convey it to the patient, to the surgeon. Actually, the patient belongs to the surgeon. We're just a service provider. We are helping out the surgeon. If something, some changes are there in the parameters of the patient, surgeon might get affected which we make sure that the surgeon doesn't even come to know what all is happening on the other side of the operating field.
Yes. So the last picture.
There I am. That's my MBBS entrance photograph. When we entered the the MBBS, and this was a picture taken when I was doing my 12th standard. So this picture was given at the time of MBBS entrance. This is, and all these pictures are of our friends, our batchmates. When we had a batch reunion in 5 years back or 6 years back, a friend of ours who is working there in that medical college got these photographs out and put it on display there. So it was fun watching us ourselves the way we used to be when we entered the medical college.
Yeah, so Dr. Geetika is in the second row towards the end. So
towards the right side, second row, the short hair one.
Yeah, with short hippie hair. So उस time में वही trend था ना. So
अभी भी मेरा वही है, but because of the lockdown they have grown up.
Okay, any one person you miss out of this particular picture?
Yeah, very the one cool. Right above me, Ashu Grover. She used to be my roommate, my best friend. Currently, she is working with ICMR in New Delhi, AIMS. I wish I can catch up more with her. She's very busy with her work there. I am here busy with my work. I wish I meet more with her more often and relate with her.
Cool,
all the stories we used to share.
What was your dream job apart from if you were not a doctor? Ab kya banti thi?
I've never thought in those ways. Yes, well, like now as my interests are changing, I can feel that I would have been a good teacher. I love teaching kids. My both the daughters, they never went for any tuition. I was the one who were taking care of their studies, and I get good compliments from my from the friends of my children. They say, "Auntie, you teach your children so well." Once there was this boy, he said something was going on regarding the adopting the another child or something. He said, "Auntie, if you adopt me, then I'll also become a topper." You know, so I think I would have been a teacher if not a doctor.
Your entire profile is so like very calm, composed, and all that. But you know, there might be the other side of you. So what annoys you, and when do you get angry?
Angry? What is angry? That question you should ask from my husband, you know. He's the one who bears all the brunt. There's a lot of turbulence behind this calm, you know. There's a lot of turbulence behind this calm. And I think he's the one who manages me in best way. He's the one who calms me down. Things do annoy me, yes. Things do annoy me at work. If I'm overworked and come home, see everything scattered, you know, things going here and there, house dirty, not managed well.
Yeah.
And suppose I'm not getting time for myself, for sitting on that couch and doing my crochet. This also irritates me. You know, I'm not getting time for that. There are days when I don't get time for myself even. I'm so busy with hospital work and other responsibilities. Then I do get irritated, yes. I'm also human.
Yeah, I agree. So, who's your favorite superhero? Matlab un dino mein, who was that one person that, like, ye agar mil gaya, so I'm ready to get married to him.
Michael Jackson, you know.
Michael Jackson, wow.
Michael Jackson. Yeah, I was always intrigued by him. The way I had his posters in my room all the way, everywhere. Yes, I used to like him a lot. But I never had those kind of fantasies, you know, as I was growing up. I think our profession don't give us more time for all these kind of stuff. You focus there, building up our career. And while I was in MBBS, I met my future husband. So there was no looking forward, or there was hardly I got any chance to you know, try more. He was the first one, and we got ahead very well.
Have you seen this movie, Kabir Singh?
Which movie, pardon?
Kabir Singh.
Kabir Singh, yes.
Yeah. I mean, it's like that shows that, you know, you have a lot of life while doing MBBS. I mean, that movie is all around, you know, doctorates, you know, people who are studying doctor. So what's your views on that?
I think that is a movie after all. movie is for entertainment. Go to a medical college, see the way we have to study. I mean, we have to slog. We have books and books to read. You see my daughter, she's in second year and she's busy all the time with her books. You know, she has to prepare for her first prof, second prof, third prof. At the same time, she has to prepare for PG entrance. We are a big population, you know, to get our choice, the field of our choice, we have to work very hard to get good marks. We are practical. Yes, we do tend to relax in between, but then that is not a very long period of relaxation. After slogging for, say, 10, 15 days preparing for a test, we get few hours to relax, and early morning, again, same schedule, same duties, same rotations, same studies, lectures, attendance. We are busy, very much busy in our medical colleges.
Cool. So I've also, you know, seen that you write diaries. So did you any time put movie tickets in your diary?
I don't watch much movies, so no, you know, no memory of putting movie tickets in my diary. I'm not very fond of watching movies.
मतलब उन ज़माने में अभी started writing diary recently और you know
I used to scribble. Right from the beginning. I used to start a diary, then leave it for months and years. I would leave, and then suddenly one day I'll pick up another diary, start with it, leave it. So I'm not a very constant writer. So
जब लिखते थे, have you ever written stuff like yeah, वो आज मुझसे बात नहीं किया. I'm very upset. Not today.
yes, I used to write. Yeah. When I had fractured my knee and I was recuperating at home, then I started writing diary judiciously, and I used to write all my thoughts that came to me, the negative thought, the positive ones. Yes, I wrote my heart out in those diaries, you know. Nobody can read those diaries.
The diaries are kept in a restricted area, or you know, it's like anybody can go through it at home.
Yes, they are kept very much into my drawers, bedside drawer. But my family is so disciplined; nobody opens anybody else's diary. My daughters have their diaries lying there. I don't read them. Similarly, my stuff is lying there. My daughters don't. My daughters, my husband, they don't. We have our own. Space. Our own limitations, yes. Everybody, and we respect each other's space.
That's really nice.
My diary is lying open. Nobody opens it up. I mean, nobody's ever thought of opening it up, rather, in my house. We give space to each other.
Well, what is the strangest thing you have eaten recently?
My own cooked food. Yes, during this lockdown, I have cooked a lot because my helping hands were not there. So I had cooked. And yes, I made so many things, exotic things, which even I couldn't eat. So those were the strange things, you know. Something which I tried to make and then they came out to be something else.
Well, you know, you're in a large family, and apart from your mom, dad, you know, your kids, husband, who's very close to you in your family members? They are bahut attached to.
Apart from my husband and my kids, my brother. I mean, he's in my heart, you know. I love him so much. We've been together throughout. We have had a very strong bond right from the beginning. I mean, we used to be supporting each other. He's 5 years younger to me. But if you look, I'm so meek in front of him. I mean, he's so strong, tall. And we are so opposite to each other, but still we carry on.
That's really cute.
Together so well. So pillar of strength. He's my pillar of strength. Maybe I am or not, but then he's my pillar of strength. He's always there. One person I can call any time in the day is my brother.
Everybody deserves a brother like that. So.
Yeah, everybody. I mean, he's a boon to me, you know.
So what is that one thing which people are not aware about Dr. Deepika or Deepika behind the scenes? मतलब लोग सोचते हैं आपको देखने के बाद they come into a certain conclusions or assumptions that okay she is like that, but what is that one thing which people are not there?
I'm a very spiritual person. I believe in God. I am not into too much of puja or something, but then deep in my heart, I know that there is an Almighty. There is a creator of this picture. So I try to read scriptures, good spiritual books, not focusing on one sect, but I want to know everything about every religion. So maybe I want to explore this aspect of life as well. To know more about the religion which is binding the whole unity, the whole universe, the religion which is dividing the whole world. I want to learn about more of it.
Okay, that's a surprise. What's your biggest addiction now during lockdown? What's your biggest addiction?
Addiction, I'm all the time doing something or the other, crochet. I think crochet is come out to be the biggest addiction in these days.
Your voice is going low and
can you hear me now?
Yeah, now it's perfect. Yeah,
I think crochet and cooking. I've taken to cooking, lot of cooking these days. I've made things which I could never dream of making, I made marble cake, pasta, pizzas, to name a few. I've made normal food like dal makhani, made paneer pasanda, and so many things which I never thought I could ever dream of making. And I've made so many drinks, slushes and mojitos. Now I can entertain my guests very well.
And you will have more guests now. You declared it in this particular platform that you're making all this. I'm sure after the lockdown, you'll have guests pouring in. They will say now, yes, Geetika has learned all this stuff. Itne saalon ne hum miss kiya hai.
Yeah, a lot of snacks also I have learned. I'll be very much ready to serve them. Earlier, I used to be scared of going into kitchen. I mean, that was an area which I could never cross. And whatever is cooked, whatever kind of food is there, I used to eat. Never thought of making it good or improvising it. Similarly, my children, they never had opportunity to get good, tasty food cooked by their mama. Now they are getting a lot of things, Some are
so
failures.
Who motivated this? Any specific YouTube channel you followed? Any specific cook on YouTube?
I'm following one, and there's a channel called Cooking Shooking, and there's this Yaman fellow. He might not be knowing me, but then I'm a great fan of his, Hello, oh, wow. Mere Chatoro, the way he comes up. So I like following him. Anything I want to see, I open his channel and follow the instructions there.
So Cooking Shooking?
Yeah, Cooking Shooking.
Okay, and what's his name?
Yaman. He's from Hyderabad. Yaman. Yeah, he's from Hyderabad.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
And he gives such good tips. I mean, the person like me can cook now.
Cool. So, yeah, Yaman, I think we should catch up because you have converted one Anastasian who was always looking at freezing people, making them paralyzed, has started cooking because of you, making good dishes because of you.
So, yes.
Yaman should be on this particular platform, so we will definitely invite.
Yeah, he should be. I think he should be. I'll be following that.
So, what's your life mantra, madam? Now you've come to a stage where you've done most of it. You're now exploring spirituality. You're doing a lot of social causes. Now, what's your life mantra? Where do you want to see yourself, and how do you want to spend the rest of your life? And what you feel should be the message for the rest of the audience here about life?
I think we should not stop growing. We should have set challenges for ourselves and keep following those challenges. Reach one, suppose we want to learn something, reach that whatever target you have set for yourself, and then get another target for yourself. Suppose I'm learning crochet at this time, I'm learning Kathak this time. And then later on, I might have another passion to follow somewhere, someday. I don't want to stop myself here only. I want to keep growing. At the same time, I want to be right very much rooted as an anesthesiologist. I love my profession. I would be very much here as anesthesiologist practicing anesthesia, and maybe later on, as I age, I might start with my pain clinic where I don't have to work in operation theaters and see only the outpatient department, patient and outpatient department, but very much practicing anesthesia.
Okay.
In fact, now at this time of pandemic and all, I was the one volunteer to work with the administration while making an ICU for COVID positive patients in our city. We have only two anesthetists who are working with government sector. So there was a lot of lack of staff for this, for making an intensive care unit for, especially for the COVID patients. So I along with four other anesthesiologists, we have volunteered to work with the government sector. Luckily, we don't have many serious patients here in our city. So we are keeping our fingers crossed. But then, yes, we are very much there to serve them. Can you hear me? I think the phone is open.
But your voice, something is blocking your mic, I think. So I think the voice is going back and forth. But
now,
now it is clear.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I tell this thing to my children also. Don't look towards Mount Everest, towards the small hills which you have to cross. Keep a goal for one hill. Reach that hill, then make another goal. And likewise, you'll keep growing.
Cool. Now, ma'am, the main question of this particular show, if you become the chief minister for 4 years, what would you focus on? What are the areas you would focus on?
Yes, to be a chief minister for 4 years, yes, that will be a great privilege, you know. I would definitely like to work for the society, and I would make sure that every child gets free and fair education, because education is the base for growth of any society, educated society. And by education, I don't mean they learn to write their name Geetika or Ravi. By education, I mean imparting knowledge, making a lot of money, investing on schools, colleges, universities, medical colleges, and creating jobs out of those education departments.
Cool. We have some compliments also rolling in.
Seeing that people are state or current, then what the priorities are. So this has taught us very much what the priorities are. So our priorities should, my government's priority should be, would be education, health. So that we have an educated society who knows how to manage themselves, take care of their health. At the same time, we have not many doctors who can take care of the patients if need be. And there's no dearth of beds in our society. So that we have and happy people and happiness quotient of it is way ahead of the whole world.
Cool. Thank you, ma'am. Very good insights. You know, very good areas that we would focus on. Education again and healthcare have been number one show. I mean, one of the points focus areas all our guests want to focus on. Absolutely correct. So I would like to, you know, thank you for, you know, being so patient and, you know, being part of the show. We had good technical issues during the show, but I really admire the way you are like, yes, let's do it. And thanks for being on the show and taking time out for this. All the best with whatever you're doing. And we are glad that you're doing, you know, a lot of stuff apart from your work, and you're setting a good example for other women out there. So thank you for joining in. So I think she froze again. But thank you, team. I think we have good audience here. Thank you, Preeti Kashyap. She is complimenting, saying that it's great to see Mami Ji. Sarita Gupta, thank you for being part of the show. Sirisha, it's an honor to know her. And thanks, Adeline. Cooking is the favorite for her too. And I think the way he opens the show is, Hi, Mere Chatoro. Chatoro, okay. So I think after the show I will get in and try to see this show. I'm sure this guy is making good things. So many fans in this show itself, so I'm sure it should be lovely. And good, Sarita. I mean, thanks for your compliments. I'm sure not everybody is volunteering to be part of this COVID thing. So glad that Dr. Geetika also volunteered to be part of it. So yeah. So thanks, guys, for joining in. I think she is having technical issues with her internet. So I wish her all the best with whatever she is doing. And we need inspiring stories like this. She seems to be a very humble person, very down to earth, not really exposed herself to media and a lot of shows. But it's nice to know her, and we need some inspiring stories like this. So you have people who are common people and have inspiring stories around you and friends around you. Do let us know. I would love to have that interaction here and make that interaction a memorable moment for both of us. Thank you, guys. Have a great day ahead and happy weekend. Let's catch up in the evening. We have another celebrity who is joining us, a person who believes that there's no limit for happiness, and it's within us who if we are limiting to happiness. So please don't miss this show at 5 p.m. Thank you.